Good morning, dear.
Morning, hon.
Why don't we own an electric vehicle?
An electric vehicle? Too unreliable.
I understand your reservations on the subject. I'll tell you all about it. Electric vehicle runs in the same way as an electrical appliance that we have in our homes. It's as reliable as your blender or alarm clock. And you can plug your car into a socket in your garage. You can fill it up at home. The battery, which charges in 8 hours, powers your car for 300 kilometers. There are even service stations that will change your empty battery and replace it with a fully charged one in minutes. With over 5,000 charging stations in Brabant, you don't have to worry about running out of power.
And electric vehicles are a lot more environmentally friendly, aren't they?
It does not need to power the engine when it's stationary and can create electricity simply through braking using the engine as a generator to slow down the car.
But what if an electric car breaks down? How on earth am I going to get it fixed?
An electric engine has far fewer moving parts and thus is a lot less likely to break down. It requires less maintenance and parts cost less. It is basic logic. What is more reliable? An engine made up of an axle and some copper wire and a magnet? Or one fueled by an exploding mixture of gasoline and air inside several pressurized chambers which have to be cooled and lubricated to keep it from breaking down? An electric engine is smaller too. So small it can be fitted inside the wheel of a car. This frees up a lot of space inside the car's interior, which in turn means more space for its occupants.
Whoa! So much more leg room, more room for the kids, and let's not forget, more room for your golf bag. Oh, men and their toys.
That's fine and all, but how are we supposed to afford a car like that? I'm not made of money.
The price of an electric vehicle will drop as soon as the technology becomes more widely used. Just look at the initial price of mobile phones when they first arrived on the market, and now compare it to today's prices. And don't forget that the cost of a car lies not only in the showroom price, but in the operating costs. The cost per kilometer of an electric car is significantly less than a gasoline-fueled car.
Right, so I'll be driving a cheap family golf cart around town? I mean, a car should also have some muscle.
Do you know that an electric engine, unlike a combustion engine, can deliver a maximum amount of torque starting at 1 RPM? A 500 horsepower engine that can unleash its power on a highway immediately as you put your foot down.
I hate those loud, fast cars that pull up at the lights.
Electric engines run almost silently in city traffic. Driving is a way to unwind. Just turn on some music and enjoy the ride.